Welcome, you guys. I am very privileged to be able to speak with you guys today. I was very excited when I was given the chance to share a devotion with you guys. If you don't know me, I'm Trisha Fry. I come from a military background. I'm from Spokane. I'm a senior at Northwest and a missions major. I'm very excited about it. And I just want to share with you guys something that I read as I was preparing for this devotion, a verse that really stuck out to me, and that is in Luke 13, and it's verses 18 through 19, and I'm going to read it for you. It says, "Then Jesus asked, 'What is the kingdom of God like? What shall I compare it to? It is like a mustard seed, which a man took and planted in his garden. It grew and became a tree, and the birds of the air perched in its branches.'" And so I just want to share that story with you, but I also want to let you guys know that as Pastor Ehler shared with you guys on Monday, that there was a group of students that had the exciting opportunity to go to Israel this past summer, and I was very fortunate to be a part of that group. And fast backtrack a little bit, I also want to share a little bit of my history. As I said, I am come from a military background. I come from a Christian household. I grew up Christian, and just one of those things you never really think of. I always thought the Garden of Gethsemane was like this Garden of Eden type place. Like, there's tons of bountiful, beautiful trees just like Seattle, and there's green grass everywhere, there's flowers. Like in my head, it is the Garden of Eden. Why I always thought that, I don't know. It was just something that I always believed to be true. And so fast forward back to this Israel trip, we had the exciting opportunity to go to the Garden of Gethsemane. And of course, there was a church right next door because, you know, wherever Jesus was, they have to put a church, obviously. So we had the opportunity to walk through the garden, and we were able to take communion and take some personal time with God and sing worship songs, and it was incredible. I still remember it to this day. Like, I loved it. But that's not what I want to focus on. I want to focus on what the Garden of Gethsemane looked like. It was not the Garden of Eden, okay? It was the desert, and for some reason, it didn't clue into me that Israel is in the middle of the desert and has been so always. Okay? Always in the desert. Why I thought it was the Garden of Eden, I don't know. So we walked in. There is no grass. If there are flowers, they're desert flowers that are slowly withering away because for some reason they thought they had a chance that they could survive. They didn't. The trees were not beautiful, bountiful trees like this. They were desert trees that you don't touch because they had needles sticking out, and they did not look pretty. And so this completely, for some odd reason, this completely rocked my world. Completely, like, shocked me. Like, what is this place? This is not where Jesus spent his last moments. Like, I just thought it was like a romantic thing. Like, he's just waiting there, and then the soldiers are gonna come in, and I was like, this is a piece of crap, piece of land. Like, I was shocked. And so I want to jump back to the verse, and it says, "What is the kingdom of God like?" This is Jesus asking a group of people, "What is the kingdom of God like, and what shall I compare it?" And so as I was reading this verse, it immediately made me think of, you know, when it goes on to say, garden, large tree, branches. That's what made me think of Israel and how I was rocked and changed. And so I wanna challenge you guys. What if Jesus asked you guys that question? What is the kingdom of God like? Some people think of it as a community of believers. Some people think of it as their personal commission to help save people, help make other people Christians. But for me, I immediately thought of the kingdom of God. Some people view it as heaven. Everybody has their own belief in what they think the kingdom of God is like. And so whether it's right or wrong, that's just what people think. And so what are the first things? If Jesus was personally asking you, what do you think the kingdom of God is like? What are the first things that come to mind for you guys? And I just want to challenge you with that. Are these things that you need to surrender to God and say, hey, God, do I have the right mentality? Is this what you want me to believe the kingdom of God is like? Or are you right on track with God, even like with God's will for your life? This is what the path is for my life. This is what I know for a fact God has called me to do. And so with these questions, I want to leave them with you, and I want to give you your own time throughout the day. Let it soak in. Let it challenge you. Think about it. Meditate on it. And really let it change your life.